red and white.
All right. Thank you, everyone. Next on the agenda, Triumph Funds. And this time I'm gonna ask you, Mayor, to kick it off.
I'm sorry, I actually need to touch base real quick.
Sorry, Chairman.
I know that most people are aware that the Berth 6 was one of my initial high-speed projects that I had intended to put forward as one of the first projects from the county. I pulled it from that list. It didn't make the final cut, only because the city's undergoing a study to find out what the final use is, what it's going to look like. I want to make sure that everybody here hears it directly from my mouth. My support for getting, it's a shame that the port is running at 80% of its capacity. My support for bringing that back in there as soon as that study is done and we know what our final end state's going to look like for that port going forward. Absolutely no one should be reading anything into it other than I'm anxious to see what the final result of that study is so that we can get moving on getting the port rebuilt.
All right. Thank you, Chairman Underhill. Okay, back to you, Mayor.
Triumph Golf Coast, for me and everyone in the audience and the public here, this is the most important thing for me as your mayor and as a public official. I think this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity and a transformational opportunity, this Triumph money. And I believe when I suggested this topic, when we had this joint meeting to the council, this was one of the most important things I wanted to discuss was this Triumph money. And as you know, Florida received $2 billion in the settlement from BP, and a billion and a half will flow to the 8 counties. And obviously, the formula that was used for Restore, hopefully we can use a similar formula for the 8 disproportionately affected counties in Northwest Florida. But I think there's many people in the audience that I see and how we can transform our community with this money, and I'm glad to see that the legislators that have been elected are really focusing on this, because when we started talking about having this joint meeting, the legislature in Tallahassee was talking something differently. And I want to make sure when that money does come down and Escambia County gets the majority of that funds, that the city and the county, and obviously Century, we split this money equally. So we don't get into what we got in with the Restore Act money. So for everyone in the audience, this is incredibly important, the Triumph Gulf Coast money. So make sure you're reaching out to your legislators and obviously us, but I'm going to be trying to champion this along with everyone else in this room, because this is transformational in a major way for our great city and county.
Thank you, Mayor. Yes, Commissioner Robinson.
Mr. Chairman, the county has certainly taken a strong position on this, trying to put forward some guiding principles. However, I don't know anything outside of sounding like it's going to be chosen by the legislators. We hope they will endorse perhaps some type of process similar to what we went through with the Restore process, that the Triumph Board will hear certain issues vetted, but it does appear at least from the speaker's current standpoint, that it's their intent that the legislators will make those decisions. So I don't necessarily know if there's a formula or something else, but the county at least moved forward in supporting, was also there to discuss at the delegation meeting what those things would be and the principles. And we've certainly said one of the biggest is just making sure that the 75% come to the 8 counties. We also indicated that we thought workforce development and infrastructure projects for economic development were important to meet with what the speaker wanted. And then we also felt very critical that the decision should be made by Northwest Floridians. I think everybody's still trying to figure out how this whole thing gets sorted out from there, but I think there'll be a lot of work between here and in the session in April. But I can tell you the county's already taken fairly strong positions on this, and at least sent in its ideas and principles on this matter.
All right. Thank you. Councilmember Myers.
Yes, well, I agree with the mayor and Commissioner Robinson. You know, we really need to get our fair share of this. But also, I like the Restore process, even though it was lengthy. that had a lot of citizens' input, and all the projects we've selected have had a lot of citizens' input, been vetted by the citizens. And so I would like to see some type of process. It may not have to be the same process you had when you had the Restore Advisory Committee, but to ensure that we have citizens' input on how these funds will be spent.
All right, council member.
Yes, from my understanding from you, Commissioner Robinson, is that the legislature will make some type of decision during this session to determine whether or not a formula of who's going to get these dollars and the principles in which they should be distributed.
I think the idea of what we've said is there ought to be some type of principles. They have indicated there's no appetite for them to do a formula for within counties or even in cities and jurisdictions outside of that. Triumph may want to do that, but they've even kind of held the hands of what Triumph can do. We're not even sure whether they're going to, you know, what's going to happen with them. So I think all of this is a work in progress, and you know, I think all of it will depend on what happens this year in this session in Tallahassee. And I would say that I'm glad to see the city is engaged in that process, because it's going to take as many of us as possible to be pulling on the same direction. But we're still struggling with what that's going to be and understanding what that's going to be as much as anybody else is.
Okay, thank you. Fellow members of council, as well as commission members, what I'd like to do now is just use this as a segue to let Commissioner Robinson just maybe conclude the discussion and expand on this. And that is, we had on our agenda, Commissioner Robinson, all of us as members of council, just as you all had perhaps an opportunity to put into the pot for today's meeting, issues. Specifically, Council Member Canada Wynn did state the BP dollars from an economic development standpoint, that was the topic that she chose. If there's anything that you feel, Commissioner Robinson, you can add at this time, most importantly, to our audience and what we as a community may be able to do, not just locally, but at a state level, how may we help our community?
Well, I think for any of us out there in the audience, is how to get involved is definitely send the stuff not only to our delegation, but certainly to legislative leadership, both the President of the Senate and the Speaker of the House. I would say anything we could do, if you represent a group or other parties, you could endorse that. We would, I think, Allison, our principles that we put forward are out there, aren't they? Yeah, I mean, somebody can look those up and find those. Jack, we can put those up on our website and just ask people to evaluate those and support those. We've got support from other counties across Northwest Florida, but as far as a specific, we have not at this point, a specific formula. At this point, I have not heard anybody say that they have a formula in an idea or what they want to do. I would strongly encourage them to do that, but at this point we didn't have a specific formula that we were going to move forward or anything else. The legislature seems to have their own desires, and we just want to make sure we get 75% in Northwest Florida.
And again, so how might we, when we visit the website, what modification are you suggesting?
We're going to try to get our, we'll be happy to get our principles that we passed, unanimously, all the principles we agreed to, we'll have them up there. If you want to take them and turn around and send them to the President of the Senate and the Speaker of the House and say you endorse this, that would be very good. If they began to get inundated by people from Northwest Florida, I think that would be very helpful for them to make sure that that was a priority initiative for them.
Okay, thank you. Yes, Councilman Vermont.
Well, I would like to suggest that either that the council executive get together with Mr. Brown, come up with those principles and draft it into a resolution that the council can vote on this month at our next council meeting.
All right. Thank you, Councilmember Wood.
Councilman Myers speaking to it.
All right.